morgon. Välkomna tillsammans till Kungliga Vetenskapsakademin och den här presskonferensen. Vetenskapsakademin har avslutat sitt sammanträde och det är dags att presentera årets Nobelpris i fysik. Jag heter Göran Johansson och är numera akademins ständige sekreterare. Och med mig här framme har jag professor Anne Lugé som är ordförande i Nobelkommittén för fysik och professor Olga Bottner, ledamot av Nobelkommittén och expert inom prisområdet. Welcome to the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences. It's time to announce this year's Nobel Prize in Physics. I am Göran Hansen, Secretary General of the Academy, and with me on the podium is the Chair of the Nobel Committee for Physics, Professor Anne Lugé, and Professor Olga Bottner, member of the Nobel Committee. I will start by reading the announcement with a citation in the five languages of the Nobel book, and we will then hear presentations from our experts on the panel. After that, we hope to have one of the Nobel laureates available on a phone line, and we look forward to your questions, of course, in Swedish or in English. Årets pris handlar om identitetsbyten hos några av universums vanligaste invånare. This year's prize is about changes of identity among some of the most abundant inhabitants in the universe. Kungliga Vetenskapsakademin har beslutat att utdela 2015 års Nobelpris i fysik till Takaki Kajita och Arthur D. McDonald för upptäckten av neutrinoscillationer som visar att neutriner är massa. The Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences has decided to award the 2015 Nobel Prize in Physics to Takaki Kajita and Arthur B. McDonald for the discovery of neutrino oscillations, which shows that neutrinos have mass. För den upptäckten av neutrinoscillationen bedogs bevisen med att neutrinos massa har. Hon har descoverte oscillationen neutrino emot följande neutrino om mass. Za kritie astilacien neutrino sto pagaziwajet sto un neutrinom jest massa. Thank you. And now, the Chair of the Nobel Committee, Professor Lugé, will give us a brief introduction. Anne, please.
At this moment, in this room, there are more than a billion neutrinos which travel almost at the speed of light. These elementary particles are the second most abundant in the universe, next to the photons, which are the particles of light. They are created in nuclear reaction, for example in the sun, in stars, or in nuclear power plants. They interact very little with the environment, for example they can go through Earth without being stopped. There are three kinds of neutrinos: electron neutrinos, muon neutrinos, and tau neutrinos. This year's prize is awarded to the experiment discovery that neutrinos can change identity. For example, a muon neutrino can become a tau neutrino and vice versa. They oscillate. The observations were made by two research groups, one at the supercandidate detector in Japan and the other at Sudbury Neutrino Observatory in Canada. The discovery implies that neutrinos, which were believed to be massless, do have a mass, even if very little. And since there are so many of them, it changes our view of the universe.
Thank you, Anne. Now, Professor Olga Bottner will give us some insight into the science behind the problem.
We have to.